Lord, I'm always saying you got through it because your mind was in a better place.
Yeah.
I was hearing someone testify, well, I think it was Sister Cody. She said, I'm not worried about nothing. I'm putting my trust in God.
Amen.
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 That's what it's going to take, because Amen. Our faith is going to be tried. As Job was tried, our faith won't be tried.
Yeah.
Satan, he'll use all kinds of things to cause us to doubt God and to give up. But what did he say again?
I waited patiently
for
the Lord.
I waited. Which means he did this thing.
Amen. That's right.
He waited patiently upon the Lord.
And he inclined unto me.
And he inclined
unto me.
You don't give up, he's going to incline unto you.
Yes.
If you don't give up and you keep on doing the right thing, you keep on doing what the Spirit instructed you to do.
Yes, Lord.
You know, sometimes we feel like we don't have the strength.
Amen.
To overcome a thing.
Amen.
You know, sometimes we feel like we don't have the strength to go through things.
Amen.
But you do. You got to remember who's living in you.
Amen.
You got to remember, amen, who did the calling, why he chose you.
Amen.
I got to listen to this morning.
Amen.
What he says again?
I waited patiently,
and that's what we have to do.
Amen.
My wife said, ain't no need to complain about the situation. It's not going to change nothing.
Amen.
Why the Bible said, all things you should give thanks.
Amen.
Amen. Despite the situation, condition, you ought to give God thanks.
Amen.
He said, you are my witnesses. He chosen us to be his witnesses.
Right.
To show the world how they ought to be. As Cody was sharing that testimony with some. Amen. That she put her trust in God.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Read on.
I waited patiently upon the Lord.
And he inclined unto me.
And heard my cry.
And did what?
And heard my cry.
Amen. Teacher Davis was reading earlier in the scripture. You know, when you seek the Lord, you're going to find him.
Amen.
Amen. If he that seeketh it, that means continue to seek.
That's right.
Whosoever asketh it, that means continue to ask. You can't ask God a thing and just knock off. You got to. See, he wants you to continue to seek him.
Amen.
He wants you to continue to knock.
Amen.
We had an elder sister when we was in Dallas under Elder Bush ministry, with an elder sister there. And me and my wife, we were having some financial problem, and Carrie, we needed $20, and she was in her car was in the driveway, and I was kind of, you know, I didn't really know the saints as good as she did, and I said, well, she knocked on the door. I said, well, maybe she's not there. She said, she in there. Carrie kept on knocking. So I said, I know you in there. And I'm out in the car. What's she doing? I said, she's not there. She ever did it, she's not there. She said, she's in there. She kept on knocking, clack, 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 clack. Sister, I know you in there. Amen.
Amen.
After a while, she came to the door. She wasn't asleep.
Amen.
She was in there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
She said, I gotta help you, because I need $20.
Hallelujah.
And that's how it is. God just keep on calling on him.
Right.
Keep on asking him for deliverance. Keep on asking him for strength.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Like a blind man. He was blind. He kept on. He heard that Yeshua was passing by.
Yeah.
And he asked him quite who was. He said, well, Yeshua now. He cried out.
Yeah.
Amen? Yeshua, yeah. Son of David, have mercy. Kept on crying. He said, shut up and try to get him to be quiet.
Right. Right.
Amen. So when you know your condition.
Right.
You know your situation.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
It ain't time to get quiet when you're going, amen, with amen.
Amen,
when you need something from
amen.
Him. I would say he cried the more.
That's right.
Yeshua, son of David, have mercy upon me.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Y'all listen to me, son.
Yeah.
We'll keep on calling
amen.
On God.
Yeah.
Me and my house, we're going to keep on calling on God.
Yeah.
Keep on seeking him. Keep on waiting on him.
Because
he's going to hear my prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, read.
I waited patiently
upon the Lord.
And he inclined unto me.
And he inclined unto me.
He heard my
and
cry.
And he heard my cry.
He brought me up also.
And he brought me up also.
Out of a horrible pit.
What kind of pit
out
I was in? David said I was in a very bad pit.
Yes.
I mean horrible.
Amen. Amen.
Sometimes we fall into a horrible pit.
Amen.
And we look for someone to blame.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
But while you're in your pit, you ought to hang on in there.
Yes.
Make sure while you're in the horrible pit, you're talking right.
Yes.
That's not even trying to describe your horrible pit to
me.
Okay, man?
Amen.
We believers know about that the horrible pit.
Yes.
Your pit is no more horrible than mine.
Yes.
The Bible says we all should drink from the same cup.
Yes.
Cup of affliction, we all are drinking from it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Are you listening to me, saint?
Amen.
And sometimes Satan make you get your hand up.
Yeah, things
we don't want to face.
Right.
Things we don't want to go through.
Amen.
Things that we actually need patience.
Amen.
To go through, because God is God. He's almighty.
Amen.
Don't need nothing from none of us.
Amen.
We need him.
Yes.
And that we have that we can give to him and make him rich.
Amen.
Or make him be a better God.
Right.
He's who he is.
Yes.
Bible said he can't deny himself. If we deny him, he can't deny himself.
Amen.
He's who he is.
Amen.
Are y'all listening to the saints?
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Yeah, that horrible pit is something that we just don't, you know, we don't like going through.
Amen.
It's because it's horrible. Because we think it's not fair.
Hmm?
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Sometimes we cry with one another.
Amen.
We feel one another's pain.
Amen.
Yes, we do.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, sister testifies and break your heart because you can understand what she's talking about.
Amen.
That's right.
Are y'all listening to me, son?
Amen.
Don't you know God is able to deliver you from that horrible
thing? Amen.
That's right.
I'm telling you, me and my wife, I'm telling you, we experienced some things in the past.
Amen.
And God brought us through it all.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Paul said, he delivered me out of the mouth of the lion.
Amen.
That's right.
Because you're in the lion's mouth, don't mean you're supposed to act the fool.
Amen.
Amen.
Some folks think they don't belong in the lion's mouth. Well, Lord, if you go in there, then you just, hey, you need to go on in there.
Amen.
Yeah, Lord, quit looking at the faint.
That's right.
Faint ain't penetrated you yet.
Amen.
And you're complaining.
Amen.
Look how big them fangs are.
Amen.
Don't make no difference how big the fangs are.
Amen.
That's right.
The Lord allow you in that guy, amen, amen. Just relax.
That's right.
A little slob ain't gonna hurt nobody.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
It took, amen, three Hebrew boys and bound and put them in the fire's front because they refused to bow down to Nebuchadnezzar and his image that he had set up for them. They refused to do it.
Amen.
And they had this testimony. They wanted the king to know it. Just in case God don't deliver him, that he's still able to do it.
Amen.
One thing about it, I don't care what your condition is, you'll never blame God.
Amen.
You'll never blame God for your condition.
Amen.
You'll never blame God. You want the world to know that your God that you serve is able to do all things. Don't think, amen, don't think I'm a curse because, amen, what's happened upon me.
Amen.
Saints of God go through affliction. Paul wrote that the saints will go through many tribulations. Tribulation.
Hallelujah.
That's why, amen, if we do this thing right, amen, we're going to receive joy unspeakable.
Amen.
Full of glory. Amen. You got to get something from God going through all this. You got to be nice to folks. Not, amen. Not nice to you.
Amen.
Sit back and see what the world is doing. All that, it's like they got having all the fun.
Right.
You sit here sweating going on.
Yes.
You got the labor for every inch.
Yes.
You got the labor for it.
Amen.
For every inch of joy.
Yes. Yes.
Every inch of peace. You try to make peace out of that thing. Yes. Because the word say make peace out of it.
Yes.
You try to make joy out of this thing.
Uh-huh.
Huh? Because the word say be joy.
Amen.
Amen. Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me this morning?
Amen.
Watch the word. Read on.
He brought me up also.
See, listen to. That's why it's good to read.
Yes.
Then when you read, read with some understanding.
Amen.
Everybody know why God put that in the book here? Because we all will be able to relate to David.
Amen.
Amen.
David was a man after God's own heart.
Amen.
And we all can relate to David.
Amen.
David said he brought me out of a horrible pit.
Yes.
A horrible pit.
Amen.
Hmm?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
But it's all right.
Yes.
It's going to be all right.
Amen.
Come on, read.
He brought me up also.
He brought me up also.
Out of a horrible
pit. Out of a horrible pit.
Out of the miry clay.
Out of the miry clay. Out of the muddy. I was really messed up.
Amen.
Hmm?
Yes, yes.
I was really low.
Amen.
Amen. Everything stuck to me.
Amen.
And I wonder why this is happening to me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But he brought me out of the miry clay.
Yes.
And what did he do?
And set my feet
listen
upon a rock.
Listen to. Not on riches.
On a rock.